When the terrorists attacked, we responded locally in a big way. Today, News 5's Courtis Fuller sat down with a member of Ohio's Task Force One to talk about his experiences then and the significance of right now. Courtis?
Well, Jack, members of the Task Force One have seen the worst of the worst when it comes to destruction, from hurricane zones to tornado alleys. But a veteran first responder says this week is a reminder of a different mindset when nature strikes and the man-made pain caused by 9/11.
It was something that you can't prepare for. I've never been to war, I've never been to battle, but when I got there, in my mind, it had to be the same thing.
Captain Mike Cayse, a veteran Cincinnati firefighter, reflecting on the up-close sights, sounds, and smells of 9/11's Ground Zero. As a member of the highly specialized group of 200, known as the Ohio Task Force One, Captain Cayse was on the scene within hours after the attack. The mission? Search and rescue.
The dust was everywhere. Everything was one color. There were helicopters and fighter planes from the military flying overhead. I mean, it was very overwhelming. It took a while just to take your breath away and grasp what was actually going on here.
Captain Cayse says the emotional scars will always be there for first responders. And he had this to say about a week that started with the killing of bin Laden, capped off today by the president's visit to Ground Zero.
I saw some things that I didn't think I'd ever see. And so now, 10 years later, you know, seeing that, hey, the person who masterminded this is now no longer able to do this ever again, it brings somewhat of a closure. And it gives me some peace knowing that the guys that I met and interacted with there now can say, the guy that did this to my buddy, my friend, is not here anymore.
Now, coming up at 6 o'clock, a special exhibit coming right here to the Tri-State to mark the 10th anniversary of 9/11.